I'm going to show you is pronator teres. Okay, pronator teres has two heads. One is a humeral head and the other one is a
ulnar
head. Okay, and the muscle is actually starting from here, from the common flexor origin and here, and they travel and it becomes a bulk over here and inserts over here. Okay, so the pronator teres is basically starts and ends in between here. So the motor point is somewhere here. So the motor point is ideally it's placed over here. Can I have the mic? Yeah. So the motor point of your pronator teres is here, slightly medial. I'll take it, medial. Yeah, so this is your pronator teres. Probably I may be have to be a little bit down, okay, but let it be here right now. This is with the pronator teres, and the next muscle that I will do is this flexor carpi radialis. Okay, radialis is a single muscle, no longus or brevis, so it's flexor carpi radialis. Obviously originates from here. Okay, originates from here and inserts at the second base of the
metacarpal.
Okay, so here it inserts. So this is the origin and this is where it is traveling, and this is going to, it actually gets inserted here. Okay, so if you look at this, so this is the bulk I expect. This is the bulk that I expect, and becomes a bulk, gets over and then becomes a tendon, and the tendon is traveling, comes here. So this is the bulk of the muscle that I expect, and the one third, proximal one third is what we are expecting, the motor point. Okay, the junction of proximal one third and the distal two third is the one that I am expecting. So this is your actually ideally then pronator teres has to be slightly down here. Okay, fine, no issue. So I am going for this as the flexor carpi radialis. Okay, so flexor carpi radialis is here second. Okay, now the third point is now what I have to do is flexor carpi radialis and
flexor
carpi ulnaris. Okay, I'll go for ulnaris. Ulnaris, if you look at ulnaris, you can see that this is the bulk, you know, you can see the muscle bulk over here. This entire bulk is actually flexor carpi ulnaris, and I can say that, you know, when I go from, this is the medial epicondyle, and this is the bulk that I'm going to have, and I'll be having the bulk, and this is the motor point of my flexor carpi ulnaris. Okay, so this is my pronator teres, this is my flexor carpi radialis, and this is my flexor carpi ulnaris. Now the next muscle that I'll be going for you is femoris longus. Anatomically may be present or may not be present in many, but even if it is present, I'll take it. Then where I am going to have it is before that I'll go for the flexor digitorum superficialis. Flexor digitorum superficialis is when you look at this entire bulk, it comes at this point. Okay, it comes at this point, that again a mid of the forearm. Okay, but at the slightly at the lower side. Okay, slightly at the unless and until unlike your extensor digitorum. Okay, extensor digitae minimae, which is exactly at the middle. This is not exactly at the middle, this is on the lower end that I will have the flexor carpi, flexor digitorum superficialis. In between these two, if you have palmaris longus, then that comes in between these two. Again, slightly on the medial aspect. Remember, all your muscles are actually originating from here, and they come and they insert over this portion. Okay, they insert over this portion. So none of the point should be going actually on the radial side. You are in the mid of your forearm, or you are going towards a little bit of the ulnar side. I don't expect any motor point to come on the radial side, because there is no muscle only on that side. Okay, this all of them are here and they get end over here. I hope you are getting it. So this is my flexor digitorum superficialis, and this is my femoris longus. Now left missed one is flexor pollicis longus. Flexor pollicis longus is the one muscle that I will expect it in the radial side. Okay, that is the one that comes in the radial side. And again, if I look at this forearm into two three one thirds, it is in the lower one third, but at the top. Okay, at the top I will have the, okay, this is proximal one third, middle one third, and the distal one third. And either you can say the middle one third ka lowest, or the upper one third ka upper, wherever you want to take it, you can take it. That's what I am going to have, but it is on the radial side. It is on the radial side. The only motor point that I'll get it on the middle radial side. The other one is flexor digitorum profundus medial fibers. It is a deep muscle. It is a deep muscle. So that since a motor point means, what is the definition of motor point?
To stimulate the
where the main nerve enters, one. Okay, or clinically where I get the maximum contraction with the minimum intensity. That is a clinical definition. But anatomically, when I say where the main nerve enters, that is applicable only for a superficial muscle, not for a deep muscle. So in a deep muscle, where the muscle emerges out, where it becomes superficial. So the flexor digitorum profundus medial fiber emerges out where this, I told you this is your flexor carpi ulnaris. This is your flexor carpi ulnaris. The bulk is here. So it is actually the bulk finishes here. So your flexor digitorum profundus starts to emerge out here. Okay. So your medial fibers, you will have the motor point over here. Okay. You will have the motor point over here. Now the lateral fibers actually comes in here. The lateral fibers, profundus ka lateral fibers actually comes here. Again, as I told you, it is becomes very crowded. So difficult to stimulate the profundus ka lateral. But if you want, for sake of doing it, we can try over here. Okay, got it? So now, can we, so these are the motor points. So motor points number, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe or may not be, whereas 5, 6. So 6 motor points, definitely I will be doing it. There are 2 motor points which are of theoretical importance, palmaris longus and that lateral part of your flexor digitorum profundus. This is very tough to get. This, if you are having it, yes, definitely I will stimulate. Okay, fair enough.